Today I'm going to be talking about the new Philips CSS2123/F7 soundbar. So we've got the box here, and we're just going to open it up and show you what's inside the box. So you get a power cord, you get a little remote, you get a quick start guide, and some safety information, and the warranty registration. The full manual can be found online at philips.com/support. So you get, once again, the quick start guide, some safety information, and the registration card. You get the soundbar itself, a power cord, a small remote, and the subwoofer. A little bit more information about this soundbar is the soundbar is very compact. You see it's only 27 inches long and 11 inches deep. The soundbar features double bass technology as well as virtual surround sound for a realistic movie experience. It creates a surround sound experience without all those extra speakers and wires. It also has a separate subwoofer which adds to that same experience. On the rear of the soundbar you'll see three different audio inputs. You will see a digital audio coaxial input, you will see a digital audio optical input, as well as an analog audio input. This port that you see there, the two plugs, that is where you plug in the subwoofer to. The cable is on the back of the subwoofer for that. On the other side here, you do have the AC power, so everything plugs into the soundbar unit. On the top of the soundbar, you see some lights here. This soundbar does not actually have any physical buttons on it. Everything's used, controlled from the remote. But you're going to see a surround sound light, coaxial light, an optical light, an auxiliary light, a music iLink light. Those represent the different source inputs. On the right side of the soundbar, you get a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, which can be used for any MP3 player that has a headphone connection on it, or you can also do analog to a 3.5 millimeter connection. This is the rear of the subwoofer. You notice the speaker right here. Be careful because it is exposed on the back of the unit, so don't touch that or puncture it when you're moving around. And this is the speaker wire. These are proprietary clips. The wires cannot be cut. They don't have extenders or different extra clips to put on it. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to plug in our power. And we're going to plug in our subwoofer cable. The subwoofer cable only goes in one way. You see the clip, and it's going to go in the clip up. It clicks, and you're connected. So this particular soundbar, unfortunately, does not support Dolby Digital. Most of your audio sources, such as TVs, Blu-ray players, cable boxes, satellite boxes, have settings. So you can change it from Dolby Digital to PCM. There's directions online at philips.com/support on how to do this. There's also directions in the user manual that's on that same website that talks more in depth about the PCM settings that this soundbar needs to have. So for this particular TV, what you can do is hook in an analog audio. Analog audio will always work. It's not going to matter whether or not the source is Dolby Digital or not. Since it's going through analog audio, the Dolby Digital doesn't transfer. So what we're going to do on this TV actually has a headphone jack on the back of it. So we're going to plug in a headphone cable. The headphone jack cable, into the back of the TV. And the other end of that headphones is analog. I'm going to take the analog and plug in the colors. Alright. So, that's all plugged into our soundbar. I'm going to take our remote control and just turn it on. You notice that the remote is fairly small. It has the source buttons on it for auxiliary, optical, coax, mute, surround, and the music iLink, and then you also have separate buttons for bass, volume, and treble, and the power button at the top. There is no display other than the LED lights that are on the soundbar, so you will just be pushing the buttons and the light will flash and you will get the changes that you use with the remote.
Products. Well, at drive time, we made a commitment to pay all of our sales advisors a salary. We did that in an effort to give all of our customers peace of mind.
We've got the soundbar audio going through the soundbar.
No one is just there to try to sell them a vehicle, nor we're there to try to add on additional products after the fact.
You do notice if you have the TV, if it's analog hooked up and the TV's on mute, it does mute the whole system.
We encourage all of our...
You can also press mute on the soundbar itself. When you do so, the source light will flash, and we unmute it.
Within a couple of weeks, we're going to open up our 94.
There's three oil changes per
year. If you're messing around and you don't know what setting it's on, and you don't like what settings, you can reset the unit back to defaults. What you're going to do is you're going to press the bass up, the volume down, and the treble up, and all the lights will flash, and it will reset.
One of our vehicles, we're giving a $350 price discount on those.
And it is now set at the default levels from when you first took it out of the box. The directions for that are in the user manual. Once again, to do the factory reset, it's bass up, volume down, treble up, and that will reset it back to the original manufacturer specifications. As I mentioned earlier, this soundbar does not support Dolby Digital, so I'm going to plug in a digital audio coax cable so you can hear what it'll sound like if the Dolby Digital is being pushed through the system and the soundbar doesn't take it. There's nothing wrong with the soundbar, it just doesn't support Dolby Digital. So it will sound similar. I'm going to switch it to coax. So that static sound right there and the flashing surround sound mode lets you know that the source is Dolby Digital and it is not supported. Like I said, most sources have settings so you can turn it off of Dolby Digital and set it to PCM. You would have to check the user manual of your source, your TV, your cable box, your satellite dish box. One of my favorite features of the soundbar is the music iLink connection. You can take pretty much anything that has a headphone jack, such as a laptop or a phone, even a desktop computer, and plug it in and get the audio from it. So we're just going to plug it into the side of the soundbar. In this instance, I'm using my laptop since we're using the phone to shoot the video. So all you do is plug in your headphone jack, turn on the device, switch it over. And now we have the music playing from the laptop to the soundbar. One other thing to note here on the inputs, on the LEDs.
Or
yours and I'll take mine. Now let me every time you push the volume button, it flashes. But when you see it all flash, that means you're maxed out. So I'm pushing the bass. The bass is maxed out for this particular on the soundbar right now. So you would have to back it down. The treble we've got all the way up as well. So that is the new CSS 2123. More information can be found in the comments of this video. Please follow the links for user manuals and frequently asked questions. I hope this video has been beneficial. Thank you.